Welcome to the Stump Mic. Yes, we're still talking about the IPL. We are talking about all the teams that are participating in the IPL. We are looking at their squad strength. We are assessing their chances. We are looking at X factors. We are looking at key players. So the team we are going to talk about today, yes, it is Mumbai Indians this time. Let me start off by welcoming our panel once again. We have all four of us again. Ayush, Mihir and Prashant. Hi guys.
Hello.
Hello.
Alare.
Kya re?
Alare.
Acha alare.
Alare.
Alare. Duniya hila denge hum. Hey. Duniya hila denge hum. Duniya hila de hum. Duniya hila denge hum. Hey. Duniya hila de hum. Duniya hila denge hum. Duniya hila de hum.
So guys, I'll let you know, Ayush is the most passionate about Mumbai Indians. The only team that comes close is West Indies. So if we talk about Mumbai's history in the last 10 seasons, they are the team who has won the most number of IPL trophies. Mihir, what is the one moment that defines Mumbai Indians for you?
I think Mumbai Indians, obviously being three-time champions, have provided us with a lot of memorable moments. But the one that stands out, six hit by Aditya Tare against Rajasthan Royals.
Here it is. He connects. The ball's travelling. It is travelling. It is into the stand. Can you imagine?
But Raidu, I remember, played a very good innings. He scored about 30 odd runs in 10 balls. And he was, and then, you know, some computations happened and we figured that if they still get a 4 or a 6 of the last ball, they can still qualify because the score will be 193 and 195. And then Aditya Tare comes out and hits it for a 6 of the only ball he faces of James Faulkner. And that was truly memorable.
I think that was not only a Mumbai moment, I think that was an IPL moment of last 10 years. I think that will come on the top.
Following that 6, Rahul Dravid got so upset, he took off his cap and slammed it onto the ground. So, I don't remember Rahul Dravid.
And Aditya Tare actually removed his shirt or something.
And ran across the field like a bad man. Some great moments provided by the Bollywood team of IPL. If we talk about the squad that they've assembled this season, at the auction, each and every Mumbai Indians fan was scratching their hair out. They had absolutely no idea what the strategy was. Like every winning season, the next season, they absolutely screw the auction up. The last time they won in 2014, next season, they let go of Dinesh Karthik. They let go of Michelle Johnson. They let go of Glenn Maxwell. This season again, they've let go of a lot of match winners. They have managed to put up a strong 11. This is the squad that is right there in front of you. If we talk about their core 5 players, we can easily identify the 5 players around which the Mumbai Indians side revolve. Obviously, there is Rohit, there are the Pandya brothers, there is Pollard, there is Bumrah, and there is Evan Lewis as well to pitch in. Other than that, they don't really inspire much confidence. The one glaring omission is that they have no Indian spinners. Wankhede is a very difficult ground to defend on, and a spinner must have come in handy. They've always had Harbhajan in their side for the last 10 years. So this year they have gone with no Indian spinners. So strong 11 can be made, but post that they are very weak and meager on options. If I talk about a key player for this season, Prashant, in your opinion, who will be the key player for Mumbai?
So in my opinion, Hardik Pandya will have a very important role to play.
Just over. Right, there you are. You called it. It's a big one. Right, there he goes again. That's a big one too.
Because we have seen that he has played some innings for India at number 4. And he has done well, like developed a skill where he can rotate the strike and he can, you know, smash the bowling around.
Okay. Ayush, being the X factor in our team, who do you feel will play that role in Mumbai Indians lineup this season?
I think that none other than the new Chris Gill that we have, Evan Lewis. I think a very exciting prospect coming out of the Caribbean, one of the most promising players that West Indies have produced in the last couple of years. And I think that was one of the shrewdest buys made by Mumbai in the auction. So I think
Ayush and players. West Indies players, better love story than Jab Harry Met Sajan. As you know, guys, in this series of videos, we are also talking about a relatively unknown player who you might not have seen play, but one you can watch out for. So Mihir, can you talk about the relatively unknown surprise factor in the Mumbai Indians lineup?
I think in this squad, Tajinder Singh Dhillon is somebody who is a surprise element. He's tonged a lot of ex-Indian national and current Indian national bowlers through the course of this season and made a name for himself. Striking at above a strike rate of 150 and a very handy bowler whose economy is less than 7.
All you people watching, remember you heard this name here first. Tajinder Singh Dhillon is the one to watch out for this season. Talking about the 11, Shant, I think obvious openers. Why don't you take us through them?
Evan Lewis and Rohit will open the innings. We saw that last season Rohit opted to play in middle order and he generally, you know, struggles when he faces leg spin or left arm spinner initially in the innings.
So who will play at one down for you, Prashant?
I will go with Ishan Kishan. He can play at a strike rate of 150-160 and can hit sixes at his will. So he's someone to, you know, watch out at number 3. One of the, you know, emerging player of this IPL season.
Maybe get a new star from this year's Mumbai Indians 11 who don't really promise too much else. Ayush, I can sense disappointment from your face when you talk about this squad already. Why don't you take us through to the next 2-3 batting positions in the order?
I think that's where the problem starts. We have talked about the top 3, but the middle order will probably contain the Pandya brothers and Pollard, which I feel will be a too high position. I think we needed another solid batsman in the middle at number 4. We are missing that.
Obviously, Tajinder Singh Dhillon, we've already talked him up so much. So, he obviously slots into our 11 at 7. Somebody I am really looking forward to see how he performs on the big stage. And then I think Pat Cummins is somebody who has been tremendous recently. I mean, across all formats, he has the ability to hit the long shots. His bowling has been tremendous. Good length, short of a good length, full bouncer. He has the variety. And he's a very, very tremendous prospect for Mumbai Indians as well this season. So, he comes in for me at number 8, yes. And of course, Mustafizur is somebody they've bought in this season. He's again a tremendous T20 bowler, giving a lot of options to them. Very good at the death, very difficult to get away. So, I think Mustafizur obviously becomes an automatic choice in the 11. Followed by Jasprit Bumrah, who is obviously Mumbai Indians' key player throughout so many seasons. Now he's become now India's key player. So and the Indian spinners that we discussed, lack of Indian spinners in the team. So Rahul Chahar is somebody who impressed last season for Rising Pune Super Giants. He is probably the only option they can try out to start with in the spin department along with Krunal Pandya. So I think that will be how they will line up. So
obvious weakness visible as a lack of Indian spinners. So any replacement that can...
An option of bringing in Akhila Dhananjay actually. Dhananjay of course is a overseas player, so that means they might have to drop either Mustafizur and then maybe bring in somebody like a Sangwan.
That is
also the case, like if one of the openers gets injured, so it will be very, you know, tough for them to replace any of Rohit or Evan Lewis. So in that case they might go with
that is the case with any of the 11 spots. They have a decent 11, but once they try to move on beyond that, there is nothing much else really on the plate.
I think just a couple of options in JP Dumini and Ben Cutting, they are pretty decent quality players. Maybe they can come in, but Indian backup probably Surya Kumar Yadav, Siddhesh Lad, Aditya Tare. Good, but IPL winning good? Probably not.
Not IPL quality, not the people who go on to win you the title probably. They might have a blinder of the season, may shut us all up, may make us eat our own words, but the prospects of Mumbai doing well this season over the entire duration are slightly low. Disappointing auction strategy from them might lead to an indifferent campaign this season. They'll have to play out of their skins to reach the knockout stages. So that was about Mumbai Indians. Ayush, any parting thoughts that you want to give us?
No, Mumbai Indians is too close to my heart. So I just wish them the best. I'm looking forward to the 7th when the first match starts. So that will show us a lot of things about where this team will go.
That was our predicted 11 for the Mumbai Indians. That was our analysis from our lens. Guys, do let us know about your probable 11 that will step out on the field on the 7th of April. I'm pretty sure that your 11 will be vastly different from ours. Do keep the feedback flowing in. It has been humongous so far and it has really helped us in working on our videos, in improving our videos. Subscribe to the channel if you haven't done that already. We are coming up with loads of new content as we get closer to the IPL. Follow the Facebook page, follow the Twitter handle. We are on Instagram as well. Keep the feedback flowing in. That is all for this video. For the next video, stay tuned.